Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU China. I'm Henry. Last time, I have made a dynamometer or fraction torque meter. It can measure the rotator speed and the torque simultaneously. Today, I will use it to do some experiments on the different motor, gearbox, etc. and explain the detailed information about torque, speed, and the relationship between them, and tell you the secret of the torque and the speed, and how to select a good motor and a gearbox. Stick around. Let's start. The experimental construction is the same as I explained last time. Use the fraction force to measure the torque. If the motor does not rotate, the torque is called stored torque. The current is called stored current. If the motor rotates freely without a load, the speed is called no load speed. The relationship between speed and the torque is linear. When speed decreases, the torque increases. I have measured the torque and the speed using Mabuchi DC 130 motor. It works just as theoretical explained. I used the power-DC motor to do a similar experiment. The result is shown here. The motor can work in 1.5V to 3.0V. I just do the experiment in 1.5V, which I can compare the results with the last time Mabuchi motor DC 130 motor. When speed decreases, the torque increases just as we expected. When I try to measure the stored current and the stored torque, the current becomes higher and higher and the motor becomes hotter and hotter. It has a high risk to destroy the motor. Also, my simple DC power supply is in a dangerous situation. It is not a good idea to measure the stored current in this condition. Please take care if you do a similar experiment. The stored current and the stored torque is calculated using a linear fit equation with the experimental data set. The stored current is 6.98 ampere and the stored torque is 4.65 millinewton meter, which is much more powerful than Mabuchi, as we have known. Then I do the experiment using mini DC 130 motor, which can work between 3.0V to 12V. For safety reason, I just do the experiments on 3.0V and 5.0V. The results are similar to the Mabuchi DC motor and the power-dash motor. When speed decreases, the torque increases. The torque can be calculated using the linear fit equation, which are 2.8 millinewton meter in 3V and 4.58 millinewton meter in 5V, respectively. It will be more powerful if applied a higher voltage. We have found that even the fraction force is small, the motor already works near the overload condition. The words decreased speed and increased torque is correct, but it is not good for this situation. So, what is the real meaning about these words? What are the secrets in the torque and speed? This is why the gearbox plays a very important role here. Let's do experiments to reveal the secrets. For measure the speed and the torque using a gearbox, I add a small piece of stand base here. Also, change the torque head for fitted output shaft of the gearbox. The data sets are listed here. This is the one gear set result. Since the gear ratio is 36 T's to 12 T's physically, the output speed is strictly one-third of the motor speed. The relationship between speed and the torque is the same as above mentioned. Since the mini DC motor can work to 12V, the 3V is in the lower voltage range, I can directly measure the stored current and the stored torque. which the results are 1.01 ampere and 7.6 millinewton meter, respectively. The current is small and the torque already over the Mavage DC motor and the power dash motor. The results used 2 and 3 gear sets are listed here. They are quite similar, with one gear set except the torque increase much higher. The stored currents are almost the same between no gear set and 1, 2, and 3 gear sets, 1 ampere each. Obviously, the mini DC motor stops rotating in 3 volts and the stored current is about 1 ampere. With the increase of the number of gear sets, the torque increase. The ratio increase also, but not reach the theoretical number 3 times. Some reasons are listed here. The gears are not perfect. The friction force hinders the performance. The DC power supply is not so stable. The measurement equipment is not very precise, etc. Even though the increase of the torque is obvious and effective, let's compare the motor speed and torque in the working current 0.7 ampere. The method is like this. Linear fitted data set. Calculate the torque under the working current 0.7 ampere. Use the result to find out which speed is corresponded. The results are listed here. We can see, in the same input condition, the motor works almost the same. The speed is about 3500 RPM, but the output speed is different because of the different number of gear sets. With the increase in the gear set, the output speed decreases, and the torque increases. So, the real meaning of these words is revealed now. Keep the motor working in high performance condition, increase the gear ratio, which increases the output speed, hence increases the output torque. This is a selection rule to find a good motor and the gearbox combination. First, find out what torque you will need in your application, and find what speed you will need also. Then choose the most suitable combination of motor and gearbox. You will need essential rotate speed and get sufficient output torque. Hope it will give you some help. Please like and subscribe. You will not regret your choice. Also, leave your comments so we can know each other. I'm looking forward to seeing you soon again. Hope you will have a nice day. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Also, click on the small bell so you will not miss the update. TBU channel is waiting for you.